more valuable to customers around the globe.
I find a tool group. I go to the ATM page on the current 305 work offsets. The typical CNC program isn't to use all of them. For example, this program. Hi, my name is Jeff Law and I'm from Haas Automation. I'm here today to talk about advanced tool management. With most machine tools, defining, calling, and managing backup tooling is complicated and time-consuming. Furthermore, on most machine tools, it's also an extra cost option. Every Haas mill comes standard with our advanced tool management functions that are very, very easy to use. To start, I need to define a tool group. I go to the ATM page on the current command screens, and I've got to give the group a number that's between 1,000 and 2,999. In this case, my tool is a half-inch end mill, tool 23. To make it easy to remember, I'm going to call this group 1023. 1023. Use the arrow keys to highlight Add and press Write. Now I've added group 1023. Now it's time for the second step in the process. I press F4 to skip to the next window, and it's here that I define the limit. What criteria am I going to use to determine that my primary tool is expired and it's time to call a backup tool? If I'm talking about a drill or a tap, it's probably number of holes. If I'm talking about a slitting saw that I know I can make 40 parts with, then I'm going to put in 40 in the usage column. But in this case, I'm interested in feed time. I know that this end mill will run for 60 minutes. So 60, right. And I've defined the limit for this tool. And now the third and final step in the process is to set up the tools themselves. F4 to skip to the next window. And tool 23 is my primary tool. 23, enter. Now I can arrow down and define backups. Tool 31 is my first backup tool. 31, enter. And 32 is the second backup tool. 32, enter. Now that I've defined my group, it's time to incorporate this group into my CNC program. In a standard CNC program, I'm going to call tool 23 with a T23M6 command. If I want to use backup tooling, I simply replace the T23 with T1023. With the advanced editor functions in the Haas control, this couldn't be easier. I go to edit mode, press F1. This brings up a series of menus where I can select find and replace text. This works the same way it would in a text editor on your desktop PC. I'm going to enter T23, right, replace with T1023, right, F to replace forward, and A to replace all. I've just replaced all my T23s with T1023. Now I can go through and do the same for the length calls. G43H23 gets replaced with G43H1023. And if I'm using cutter comp, I'll do the same for the diameter calls. G41D1023. And now as I run this program over and over, the CNC control will read the T1023 command and will look next to the Advanced Tool Management page. If the primary tool has life remaining, it'll call that tool to the spindle first. If not, it'll scan through the list and find the first backup tool that does have life remaining and call that tool to the spindle. Regardless of which tool winds up in the spindle, the CNC control is always going to load the corresponding length, diameter, and pull offsets. And that's it. In a few simple steps, I've incorporated redundant tooling into my program.